Hey, this is Dave from GravityWiz. Today I'm going to give you a crash course on our new plugin, GravityForms Google Sheets. First thing to do is to connect your site to Google. We have some awesome instructions in our documentation, so we're going to jump right into the form. I have one form here. It's my magical form. Let's take a look at the fields that are on this form. You'll see we have a name field, an email field, and a dropdown with a selection of our favorite spells. So let's look at how to get this data submitted from this form into Google Sheets. So we've gone over to the Google Sheets tab, and we're going to go ahead and create a new Google Sheet feed. The name will be generated by default, but you can customize this however you want. Now, Google Sheets supports creating a new sheet or selecting from an existing sheet. In this case, we're just going to create a new sheet. Now, when creating a new sheet, one of the first things you're going to want to do is to create a column mapping. And the column mapping tells the Google Sheets plugin what data from your entries should be sent to Google Sheets and in what columns it should be mapped to. So we're going to go ahead and create a couple columns here. We have entry ID, and now I'm doing first name, mapping that to the first name input. And we'll do last name and map that to the last name input. And then lastly, we're going to go ahead and capture the email. Awesome. Next up, there are a couple additional options. We have the ability to update and delete rows in the sheet when entries are edited or deleted or marked as spam. We're going to go ahead and enable this, and we will test this later on. Lastly, we have the ability to do conditional logic. And what conditional logic lets you do is control whether or not the entry is sent to Google Sheets depending on data submitted in that entry. For example, we could say the email is not empty, we want to send it. Otherwise, if it is empty, we don't want to send it. In this case, we're just not going to test that here. So let's save the settings. And now that the settings are saved, we can test our sheet to see that it was created. So there you go. Entry ID, first name, last name, email. And that matches our column mapping. Entry ID, first name, last name, email. Awesome. Let's go ahead and submit a test entry. We'll do Dave Smith, dave@smith.com. And we're not going to select a spell. As soon as we submit the form, you'll see that the entry was automatically added to our sheet. Let's go back to this page again and submit another entry. And we'll submit the form again. Again, you'll see that the entry has been immediately added to the Google Sheet. So let's take a closer look at these entries. Looking at Jane Awesome here, we can see in the Google Sheets meta box that it tells you the date that it was inserted and also provides a quick link to the sheet for quick access. Now let's try editing this entry. Let's say this is jane@reallyawesome.com. As soon as we update this, we'll go here and you'll see that the email is updated in real time in your Google Sheet. Now, let's say that we decide to move this to trash. You'll see that the entry has been deleted from your Google Sheet in real time. Lastly, let's restore this from trash. And you'll see that the entry is re-added to the Google Sheet with all of the data intact. That's it for this crash course, but there's tons more to learn about this plugin. So check out our documentation. And if you have any questions, reach out to our legendary support. Thanks a lot.